Alright guys, welcome to another episode of Heavy Rain. So, as you guys know, from the previous episodes, I made really bad decisions and will lead two persons to die. And, like, two big person in the story. FBI and medicine. Well, I feel bad, but it is what it is.
Sean! Can you hear me? Daddy's here. I'm gonna get you out of there.
Let's go, boy.
Gotta open this goddamn grate. Gotta find something, fast. I'll get you out of there, Sean.
It's not gonna work. Is it? No. Oh, it did. Go. I think he just stuck. It couldn't be that easy. Oh, it's not. It's easy. Okay. Got him. Let's go.
My God, Sean, answer me.
What? He's not there?
Don't have me, son, please. Breathe. Gotta breathe.
Come on. Live, little one. Live.
Don't leave me. Sean.
Come on. Continue. No, it's not dead. I don't believe. Come on. Was I late? Oh yeah, I knew it. I knew this. I knew this would happen.
Oh, I thought you were gone.
Dad, I knew you would come and save me.
I know you know. Oh my God, dude. What a psycho.
Sean, listen. You are the best thing that's ever happened to me in my life.
Oh no, we're gonna die. I forget
I
the poison.
Whatever happens, I love you more than anything in the world.
He's not gonna die.
I'm not dead. I took the poison an hour ago, and I'm not dead.
I knew this was going to happen. Because so obvious, like... All he wanted to see if a dad could save his son. All he wanted to see...
My father didn't lift one finger to save his son.
Who are you?
Oh, you don't know me, Ethan. Oh, but we've met before.
Okay, what's this?
I have been looking for a long, long time, Ethan.
Wait, did you kill my son?
Looking for a father that would be able to do what mine could not do. sacrifice himself to save his son. Oh, I searched. Oh, I searched. Searched. But they all failed. And then I remembered you.
All those murders? Just to find a father capable of saving his son?
Just to find a father? Have you any idea how it feels to know you've been a worthless nothing in your father's eyes? Believe me, I've suffered just as much as my victim.
But you kill them and you're alive.
You're completely fucking mad!
Go ahead, you can kill me now.
Origami killer.
It doesn't matter anymore. You've accomplished what I wanted to see.
You manipulated me, but now it's over. I have my son. You have no power over me anymore. You're gonna have to face up to your nightmares on your own now.
You're gonna suffer all this blood on your face, on your hand. I thought you're a good guy, dude. Fuck me. This is, I know for sure. When I was watching this, when I was like 12 years old, something. When I discovered this guy was the bad guy, I just started thinking, okay, from now on, if someone is like nicest person ever you've seen, still can be bad. Never know. Shows, once again shows me and reminds me that you cannot trust anyone. Oh my god. How long? 3 days he was here, bro. Like, what the fuck?
All this is over now. No more trials to prove my love. No more letters for the hangman.
Well, the medicine is dead.
I hope he can find a way to live with what happened. I'll be there to help him. I'll show him every second how much I love him. I'll tell the police everything. Sean will explain what happened. Then they'll know I'm innocent. I'm not his judge. I'll leave him with his demons. All I want now is to live a normal life again.
Dad. Don't leave me.
I gotta push open the door if we're gonna get out of here.
I never want you to leave me alone again, Dad.
I promise. I never will, Sean. I promise.
I'm scared now. What the fuck? Oh. Oh, the police is here too. Oh no. What the fuck is going on? Bro, take the kid with you! Call ambulance, someone take ambulance. Take the kid. God, dude. Take the kid. Okay, what the fuck? all this for nothing. I mean, at least your son is alive. Holy shit. God damn it. What the fuck?
There was general relief this morning when the police announced that they had found Sean Mars alive more than 4 days after his disappearance. Mars was found wandering in the Old Docks neighborhood, exhausted and disoriented. It is believed that he managed to escape from the origami killer who had kidnapped him. The investigation is currently on hold while child care specialists wait to interview the boy in hopes that he can provide some new information on the origami killer. Police are still at a loss as to the identity of the so-called origami killer, who currently remains at large. In a related tragedy, it was learned that the investigation has cost the life of Madison Page, a young reporter covering the origami killer story. We're just getting word that the investigation into the origami killer has had a tragic outcome. Ethan Mars, father of the kidnapped boy and suspected of being the origami killer, has been killed in a police operation. Circumstances surrounding this tragedy have not yet been made public, but it is understood that Captain Leighton Perry and Lieutenant Carter Blake have both been suspended, pending a full police investigation.
Well, I can say I fucked it up. I played it really bad, and yeah. I mean, they cannot be always good story, guys. Come on, okay? Stuff happens. Life sucks. I'm sad though. I just 3 person died now. At least he's alive. That's what Mars would want.
Come on, Sean. You've got to go now.
Why did they shoot him, dude? Fuck's sake. That bitch. It's so hard to play this game right, man. What you gonna do now, Shelby? God damn it. I mean, I wanna play this game again. I wanna see all outcomes. What? Oh. I mean, she died. There's no... No, they said she died too on the television, so... Unless she survived somehow. But I think they're gonna show, like... Where's the graveyard of her or something.
Journalist Madison Page was laid to rest in Charity Cross Cemetery today. Her heroic death while investigating the disappearance of Sean Mars has made a lasting impression on the whole country. Colleagues from the press are united in paying tribute to this courageous journalist who sacrificed her life in the search for truth. I'm Brittany Sanders for ICN.
Okay, Brittany, it's a wrap.
Oh my God, it's lagging.
Great. Let's get out of here. All this hokey claptraps made me hungry.
This is fucked up. It happens in real life too. That bitches. Just like, they show like, oh, we care too much. After the camera, they don't even care shit. Oh yeah, this guy. Fuck.
He's being buried in 2 days in some godforsaken hole in the back end of beyond near Washington. I have to attend as a matter of protocol.
I'll pass. Jaden and I didn't see eye to eye on much.
No problem. I understand.
Hey, sir. I still have his glasses. What should I do with them?
Well, we won't be needing them again. Do whatever you want with them.
Is he gonna equip it? He will. What the fuck do you do, bro? Do what you wanna do. What are you waiting for? He's gonna shit his pants. Lord. You don't have the glow. This is worst ending I ever seen. Fuck my life. What? What the fuck? He just shit his pants for real. He killed so many kids, dude. Like, god damn it. And I think this is his perspective of being lost. He don't know what to do now. Well, it was heavy rain. Literally. Okay, this is the credits. Wow. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I wish I could give you guys a better story, but I couldn't. Well, I will see you guys in the next stories. So take care and peace out. Stay back!